Hey, fellow space enthusiasts. Turns out, dark matter may not exist. Then what happens to the theories of gravity? Well, there are quite a few types of theories on gravity. But recently, a paper was published by a fellow scientist from Sejong University of South Korea that claims to have found strong evidence for an alternate theory of gravity called MOND. One that doesn't need dark matter to explain observation with the universe and instead just tweaks the equation for gravity slightly. So if you ever wondered about the mysteries of dark matter and the latest buzz in the world of physics theories, you are in for an epic cosmic journey today. Welcome to PhysxX Space, and we are about to embark on an exploration that will keep you both entertained and informed. So get comfortable, grab some popcorns, and let's dive headfirst into the captivating world of MOND, dark matter, and enigmatic Gaia data. First things first, let's unravel the enigma that is MOND, Modified Newtonian Dynamics. It's like Newton's equations for gravity got a cosmic makeover. Specifically, when gravity's accelerations are tiny, like on the outer edge of galaxies. Now, we all know and love Einstein's general theory of relativity, the heavyweight champ of gravity theories, and it is the most accepted theory of gravity. But it comes with a twist. General relativity tells us that gravity is caused by massive objects curving the space around them. The more massive the object, the more extreme the curvature. And every test of general relativity has passed with flying colors, matching our observations of the universe, making it most widely accepted theory of gravity. But here's the kicker. General relativity also tells us there is more mass in galaxy clusters and the universe as a whole than what we can see and receive light from. Even if we account all the things that doesn't give their own light, like planets, black holes and dust, it's still not enough to explain this missing mass. This is where dark matter comes into play. There is roughly 6 times more dark matter in the universe than normal matter, and this concept has been the accepted theory since the 1960s or 70s. We still don't know what dark matter is made of, and particle physicists have yet to find evidence for a particle that could behave as we observe dark matter does. To tackle this cosmic conundrum, scientists have proposed alternate theories of gravity that don't rely on dark matter to explain our universe's observations. Among these theories, the most well-known and studied is MOND, which was first proposed in 1984 by Bekenstein and Milgrom. MOND, much like Einstein's general relativity, reverts to good old Newtonian equations in everyday situations. However, when gravity's acceleration gets exceptionally low, such as on the outskirts of galaxies where stars move at unexpected speeds according to general relativity, MOND steps in with its unique equations for gravity. Now, don't get too excited just yet, because MOND's predictions haven't always been spot on. While it does a great job explaining the rotation speeds of stars on the galaxy's edges, it flatters in other areas. If you are curious about a deep dive into this, Banik and Zhao's 2022 review covers all the tests conducted on MOND. The point is, MOND is a contender in the gravity theories arena, but it's not the reigning champion. Alright, moving on to the nitty-gritty of testing MOND. Back in 2012, Hernandez, Jimenez and Allen proposed a novel way to put MOND to the test. They suggested observing binary star systems in the Milky Way. These binary stars would need to orbit each other at specific distance, roughly around 10 light years, to enter a regime where MOND's equations would differ from general relativity, which reduces to Newtonian equations in this scenario. To pull off this cosmic experiment, researchers had to meticulously track the positions and velocities of these binary stars in all three dimensions: up, down, forward and back, left and right. The aim was to derive a model for their orbital behavior, particularly their orbital velocity in relation to their separation distance. In the realm of general relativity, you would expect a straightforward pattern depicted by the diagonal red line on the graph. However, MOND predicts a divergence at large separations with higher relative velocities than Newtonian gravity would suggest. But here's where plot thickens. The data available in 2012 was far from ideal. It came from ISA's Hipparcos mission, which ran throughout the 90s. Unfortunately, the data was plagued by inaccuracies, partly due to limitations in measuring velocities and positions of individual stars. There were many unknowns, like the accurate mass of the stars, the inclination angle of their orbits, and the eccentricity of their orbits. Factors that introduced significant uncertainty into the velocity calculations and resulted in a scatterplot of data that resembles pure chaos. Fast forward to 2013, when ESA's Gaia mission came up to play. Over 5 years, Gaia meticulously catalogued the positions, velocities, colors, and brightnesses of over a billion stars in the Milky Way. With this precise data in hand, scientists had the tools they needed to re-evaluate MOND's predictions by using binary star systems. The first paper to dive into this challenge was authored by Hernandez, Cookson, and Cortes in 2022. They analyzed Gaia's data to observe how velocity changed concerning separation distance. Despite Gaia's precisions, the data remained scattered, and neither the Newtonian predictions nor MOND seemed to provide a perfect fit. In early 2023, Portus and Sutherland joined the fray, analyzing Gaia's data as well. Their conclusion was quite a twist. Newton's theory of gravity appeared to fit the data better than MOND. But as the saying goes, third term's the charm. Hernandez once again tackled the Gaia's data in 2023, this time with what they claimed to be a more rigorous approach. Surprisingly, they found that MOND offered a better fit to the data, specifically a version of MOND known as AQUAL. But hold on to your cosmic hats, because there's more to the story. Enter Che's research paper. Che also harnessed Gaia's data to conduct the same test, plotting separations against calculated orbital velocities. The results? Well, the gray points in their graph represents the data, while the red dashed line shows the typical Newtonian predictions, and the red dotted line represents MOND's predictions due to its deviation at lower accelerations. But Che argues that at smaller separations, where the stars experience higher accelerations, the data aligns with Newtonian predictions. However, at large separations, where lower acceleration takes over, the data seem to favor MOND, specifically the AQUAL version. They even claim a significant discovery with a statistical significance of 10 sigma, implying a minuscule chance of this being a statistical fluke. How minuscule, you ask? 1 in 10,000 trillion. Now you might be thinking, hold on, how can they claim such high significance with all that scatter in the data and those pesky unknowns like inclinations and eccentricity? Well, their defense hinges on a simulation that shows Newtonian gravity also produces scatters similar to what they observe in the data. In essence, they suggest that despite the uncertainties, their findings are robust. So where does this cosmic drama leave us? Four separate papers, all using the same Gaia data, yield wildly different conclusions. MOND or Newtonian gravity? It's a perplexing situation, and amidst all the excitement and controversy, it's essential to remember that extraordinary claims demand extraordinary evidence. We are not quite there yet, given the discrepancies in the result. But there's hope on the horizon. Some insiders in the field hint a forthcoming paper using Bayesian statistics, a method that accounts for unknowns in the model. This approach could provide more clarity and potentially help us decipher whether MOND or Newtonian gravity reigns supreme. Keep your eyes peeled for that paper, as it is expected to make waves in the scientific community by the end of this year. So subscribe, as I'll keep you updated when the new paper comes out. Meanwhile, keep your eyes on the skies and keep wondering, for the future is space.